सो हेलो एवरीवन एंड वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 247। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइस इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस सम मोर क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम द पीआईबी न्यूज व्हिच आर रेलेवेंट फॉर द ईएसआई सेक्शन ऑफ आरबीआई ग्रेड बी एंड नबार्ड। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन गाइस, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन इफ यू आर न्यू हियर डू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस दिस बेल आइकन ताकि आपको वीडियोस की नोटिफिकेशन टाइम टू टाइम मिल सके। सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन गाइस। इंडियाज फर्स्ट न्यूमोकोकल conjugate vaccine has been developed by Serum Institute of India Private Limited. The question is under which brand name the vaccine has been developed. So guys, India ka pehla pneumococcal conjugate vaccine aa chuka hai that will protect the infants, that will protect the children, that will protect the adults from bacterial infection and most importantly pneumonia. Ye jo vaccine hai ye pneumonia se protect karegi and other bacterial infections which are caused by the pneumococcal bacteria. So pneumococcal guys is a bacterial family jiski wajah se kuch bacterial infections ho jate hain human beings mein, and this vaccine will provide protection against those diseases and most importantly it is helpful against pneumonia. All right, and it has guys been developed by Serum Institute of India in partnership with Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. And what is the brand name? It's Pneumosil. Okay, what is the brand name? It's Pneumosil. So you have to remember the brand name. And guys, this news is important because it is India's first pneumococcal conjugate vaccine. All right, so that is why it is important. And two, three things here that you have to remember. Number one, it is India's first pneumococcal conjugate vaccine. It has been developed by Serum Institute of India Private Limited in partnership with Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation under the brand name Pneumosil. Okay, so these are the only two, three things that you have to remember. And guys, this question can be asked in the one marker of ESI section of RBI grade B. Okay, so therefore the correct answer to this question, question number one, is what? Option A, Pneumosil. Option A, Pneumosil is the correct answer. And now let's move on to guys question number two, which is again a very important question. In today's session guys, we are going to discuss four questions which are very important for exam. Okay, all the four questions are very important. Which campaign will be launched by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs? It is saying that it will be launched because it will be launched during 4th of January, starting from 4th of January to 22nd January. Okay, abhi launch hua nahi hai, launch hoga. So it will be launched by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs to train the street vendors in digital payments who have availed the loans under PM Swanidhi scheme. So you must have guys, you must know about PM Swanidhi that we have discussed later and that we have discussed earlier. तो पीएम स्वनिधि स्कीम जो था वो गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया ने लॉन्च किया था टू प्रोवाइड 10,000 रुपीज लोन टू द स्ट्रीट वेंडर्स। ओके, स्ट्रीट वेंडर्स के लिए 10,000 रुपए का लोन दिया जाता है अंडर द पीएम स्वनिधि स्कीम एंड दिस वाज लॉन्च्ड दिस ईयर ओनली आफ्टर द ड्यूरिंग द पैंडमिक टू प्रोवाइड दिस लोन टू द स्ट्रीट वेंडर्स। ऑलराइट, एंड दिस कैंपेन और यू कैन से दिस ड्राइव इज नोन एज व्हाट? मैं भी डिजिटल ड्राइव। ओके, मैं भी डिजिटल ड्राइव will be launched by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs from 4th of January to 22nd January 2021. And why this campaign will be launched? So it will be launched to train street vendors guys in using digital payments. All right. And talking guys more about this campaign or this drive. So over 10 lakh street vendors across the country who have availed this loan of 10,000 will provide training in digital payments, how they can use their mobile phone for digital transactions. Okay. And for this, the mobile phone of the vendors will be equipped with the required technology, with the required application through which they will be provided training of how they can use the digital transaction. And one more thing, that they can also pay for material they procure from the sellers using their unique QR codes. Basically, digital transaction, chahe wo khareedne wala ho, chahe wo bechne wala ho, dono ke liye jo street vendors hai, unke liye unko training provide karai jayegi so that they can use the digital transactions while buying or selling. All right. So therefore guys, the correct answer here should be what? Maybe digital. Option C, maybe digital, because we have been asked about the campaign. So maybe digital is the name of the campaign. Therefore option C will be the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 3, which is again a very important question guys. So you have to consider the following statements regarding World Economic League Table 2021 report that has been released by Center for Economics and Business Research. So Center for Economics and Business Research guys is a US based think tank, and you have to identify the incorrect statement here. So let's talk about the key highlights of this report. So these are some of the key highlights, and these are very very important. These can be asked in your exam. Okay, one second. Yeah, सो इन 2020 इंडिया इज द सिक्स्थ लार्जेस्ट इकोनॉमी इन द वर्ल्ड. इससे पहले इंडिया वॉज फिफ्थ लार्जेस्ट इकोनॉमी. इंडिया सरपास्ड यूके बट नाउ इन द 2020 बिकॉज ऑफ द कोरोना वायरस पैंडमिक. बिकॉज इंडिया इज वन ऑफ दोज कंट्रीज विच हैव बीन हिट हार्ड ड्यू टू द कोरोना वायरस. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट इंडिया इज करेंटली द सिक्स्थ लार्जेस्ट इकोनॉमी इन द वर्ल्ड. एंड जो यूके था वो इंडिया से आगे निकल गया दोबारा से. इट इज करेंटली एट द फिफ्थ पोजिशन. बट टिल 2025 इंडिया विल बी द फिफ्थ लार्जेस्ट इकोनॉमी सरपासिंग यूके. इंडिया विल सरपास यूके टिल 2025 एंड इंडिया विल बिकम द फिफ्थ लार्जेस्ट इकोनॉमी टिल 2025. ओके एंड वॉट अबाउट टिल 2030? दैट्स वेरी गुड न्यूज फॉर ऑल ऑफ अस. टिल 2030 India will be the third largest economy, overtaking UK in 2025, Germany in 2027 and Japan in 2030. Okay, 2030 तक इंडिया दुनिया की तीसरी लार्जेस्ट इकोनॉमी हो जाएगी. नंबर वन पे होगा चाइना एंड नंबर टू पे यूएसए. एंड द रिपोर्ट प्रेडिक्टेड दैट इंडियन इकोनॉमी विल एक्सपैंड बाय 9% इन 2021 एंड 7% इन 2022. एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट टिल 2028 चाइना विल सरपास यूएसए to become the world's largest economy. और ये काफी surprising है because ये 2028 बहुत जल्दी है. ये 2035 के आसपास predict किया गया था that China will surpass USA to become the world's largest economy. But now this think tank is saying that yes, till 2028 China will surpass USA to become the world's largest economy and India will be the third largest economy till 2030 and India will surpass UK in 2025. Germany in 2027, Japan in 2030. Currently, India is the sixth largest economy in the year 2020, while it will surpass UK till the year 2025 to become the fifth largest economy of the world. All right. So I hope guys these points are clear. And talking about some GDP projections, so RBI ne project kiya hai that in the financial year 2021, our GDP will contract by 7.5%. While NCAER is saying that our GDP will contract by 7.3%, while S&P is saying it minus 7.7%, ADB is saying minus 8%. Okay, so there are various GDP projections. So guys, these GDP projections you have to learn before your exam. Jo bhi exam se pehle ka jo bhi latest GDP projection hoga, that you will have to learn. And uske liye of course, a galak session I will take. So now let's come back to the question. So you have to identify the incorrect statement here regarding this report. In 2020, India is the fifth largest economy. No, in 2020, because of pandemic, India is once again the sixth largest economy. So this statement is incorrect. Till 2030, India will be the third largest economy. Of course, this is absolutely correct. And the report predicted that India's economy will expand by 7% in 2021. This is incorrect, guys. In 2021, India's economy will expand by 9%, while this 7% is for the year 2022, which means this statement is also incorrect. So we have first statement, which is incorrect, and third. Therefore, option C, only 1 and 3 will be the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 4, which is again a very important question. Through which of the following portal, ISRO has released initial data from Chandrayaan 2 to the general public? So आप सबने सुना होगा कि इसरो ने रिलीज कर दिया है जनरल डेटा रिलेटेड जनरल डेटा फ्रॉम द चंद्रयान 2 टू द जनरल पब्लिक. सो यू मस्ट हैव हर्ड दैट इसरो हैज रिलीज्ड द डेटा फ्रॉम चंद्रयान 2 टू द जनरल पब्लिक. बट हियर द क्वेश्चन इज थ्रू विच पोर्टल दिस डेटा हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड. सो गाइज लेट मी टेल यू द आंसर. दिस पोर्टल इज वॉट? प्रदान. ऑप्शन सी, प्रदान पोर्टल हेयर इज द करेक्ट आंसर. एंड दिस प्रदान पोर्टल गाइज is hosted by Indian Space Science Data Center. Okay, Indian Space Science Data Center is Pradhan portal ko host karta hai. And what about this ISSDC? So it is a nodal center of planetary data archive for the planetary missions of ISRO. ISRO ke jitne bhi planetary missions hote hain, usse related jo bhi data hota hai, that is being kept by Indian Space Science Data Center and it is located in Bengaluru at a village which is known as Bialalu village in Bengaluru. All right. So here, this is very important question, guys. This can be asked in an exam through Pradhan portal, which is hosted by Indian Space Science Data Center. This data from Chandrayaan 2 has been released by ISRO to the general public. All right. So therefore, here the correct answer should be what? Option C, Pradhan portal. Okay. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.